You're watching the 2016 Geico ESPN High School Football Kickoff, part of Summer of Next. Bishop Gorman, the visitors from Nevada, leading Cedar Hill 17-7 in a battle of a national power and a premier Texas high school football program. And A. Schroff alongside former Longhorn Ahmad Brooks. We thought we'd be talking about the two quarterbacks, one going to Notre Dame, one to Ohio State. Instead, it's this Bishop Gorman defense. Five Division I prospects on that front 11, and they've looked incredible.
Well, they're everywhere that the Cedar Hill Longhorns are trying to throw the football, and you'll see it here. Started off early in the ball game. You see here Perry making a fine play on the ball. That really set the tone. But watch how they're playing behind the line of scrimmage, and Nati Ote has been phenomenal all game long, chasing down ball carries. There you see him swarming. Excellent play there by Bolden, reaching up. Nowhere to run for this Cedar Hill Longhorns offense. And when you look at it, Bishop Gorman has more rushing yards than Cedar Hill has total yards. They only have 3 rushing yards, 105 pass yards. That is not what this team was expecting. They'll have to come back here with new energy and more production on offense.
Cedar Hill will get the ball to receive half number 2.
Look at that face.
They'll get it at the 25-yard line, yeah. Let's take a look at our first half stats brought to you by Geico. Tate Martel, the Ohio State commit, 89 total yards. He's been sacked a couple of times. Avery Davis, 11 for 17, 105 yards, a touchdown, and a pick for the Notre Dame commit. The offensive star in the first half has been the middleman, Biaggio Ali Walsh.
Yeah, I mean, 118 yards. He's just really done it. And he's done it. You know, you would think with a player with his speed, he would have done it outside the tackles. The bulk of his yardage has come right in between the tackles. And he's really just putting in work on this Cedar Hill Longhorns defense.
Davis to the air is going to take a shot downfield. He wants Rambo, who comes back to the ball and makes the catch inside the 40. Terrific recovery by the Oklahoma commit, Charleston Rambo.
Yeah, that's the matchup they wanted, and I love what Coach McGuire came out and did after halftime. Take a shot downfield, and he went to one of his top wide receivers. That time there, Avery, as I said earlier in the day, does a great job of throwing that touch pass, allowed his wide receiver Rambo to come back over a shorter Oliver and make the catch.
Rambo lined up up top against the four-man rush. Davis stands in and then goes down, sacked by Patrick Beckner, the senior.
Man, you know, Mr. Beckner here, watch him. I mean, he just completely runs through this tackle. A nice job with his hands on the outside there working against Cub. Just great job of controlling him. And then once he got back there, great job of tracking the quarterback and putting him in the dirt.
Parker Cup, the right tackle, has an offer from Southern Miss. Second and long. Davis airmails his intended target, Fleeks. Fleeks, a junior, plays that flex position, wide receiver, running back, and he's got a few FBS offers as well. Illinois, Houston, SMU, Iowa State, and a Texas Tech.
Cedar Hill's got to do a better job of handling the pressure. That time there, that was zero coverage across the board, meaning everybody was blitzing. They only had guys in coverage, and Cedar Hill could not take advantage of it.
Empty set. Here's the blitz. Quick release. Fleeks with nowhere to go. Erased by Alex Perry, the four-star corner who recently decommitted from Arizona State.
Yeah, you've got to be able to see through the ball to make this play out on the edges. And Perry, just a fine player there. Awareness to be able to see what is coming. If you're Cedar Hill right now and you're Avery Davis, the senior quarterback, and you're in your home stadium, you've got to come back, gather up your offense. I want to bark at him. I want to talk to him. Whatever you said in the locker room right now, offensively, was not working. So you've got to come back to the drawing board and make sure you can keep this game close so that you'll have an opportunity in the fourth quarter to win.
Kylan Ritchie on to punt it away. Alex Perry and Bubba Bolden back deep, but it's a fake punt. Bishop Gorman able to make the stop, and it'll be a turnover on downs. It was Foreman on the direct snap. And the Gaels will get the ball back at the 41-yard line.
I think you're seeing the mentality of this Cedar Hill team and also Coach Joey McGuire. They come out, go over the top the first play, then they come back, roll the dice again on the fake punt. And typically in between the 40s, you're always told on defense or return units, that is when teams like to run the fake, because you still have enough field position. You don't put your defense in a horrible spot. So let's see if this Cedar Hill defense can come back out and get the ball back for their offense.
Biaggio Ali Walsh, the Cal commit to the 45, a gain of four. Ali Walsh last year put up video game type numbers, almost 2,200 yards, 30 rushing touchdowns, 33 total TDs, and averaged 12 yards per carry. And remember, Bishop Gorman plays a national schedule, so he was doing these, he's putting up these kind of numbers against quality out-of-state programs along with the Nevada competition.
It's impressive.
Receiver wide open, it's Naylor, bounces off one defender. That was Jalen Freeman, but he stepped out of bounds. Still a first down, a gain of 13. We mentioned it early in the game. Tyjon Lindsey is back with Bishop Gorman. The paperwork has not gone through, so he hasn't been cleared to play. On top of that, he's got a collarbone injury that's going to keep him out. So Bishop Gorman told us they're not exactly rushing the paperwork through. They want him to get healthy first, but Lindsey was Tate Martel's favorite target and his blood brother. Martel will keep. And he is wrestled to the ground back at the 45-yard line. It's a loss of three. There is Tyjon Lindsey, who committed to Ohio State as well just this week. Did it with a clever dodgeball video along with fellow ESPN 300 wideout Trevon Grimes.
That kid is dynamic. He reminds me a lot of Christian Kirk from A&M. I mean, just the ways that you can use him. He's a player that you can move laterally behind the line of scrimmage. Certainly a guy in your bubble game, quick passing game that can get involved. Ohio State and Urban Meyer, they've got a player that they certainly are waiting on there in Columbus.
Miscommunication between Thompson Robinson and Martel.
Well, you'll see, and we had the Chandler game last year. This was the first play of the game. They just throw it out to him on a bubble screen. You see the nasty cut there to set up the defender. Next play, they come back with a play right to him, right across the middle of the field, and watch his patience. And then the young man, just his route running ability, his awareness to get over the top of coverage, allowing Tate Martel to lay it up. But Tyjon Lindsey is a dynamic football player, and one that I think the college football world will become very familiar with in years to come.
Not a big guy, just 5'9", but boy, does he have some shape. Flag on the play. Martel sprints across the middle. If the play stands, it's a first down. Martel takes it inside the 30, 15 yards again, if it stands.
Personal foul, chop block, offense, number 68 to 78. Be a 15-yard penalty, replay third down.
Zach Rent and Christian Martinez, the guilty parties.
And you see it there, just trying to get a hold of, I believe that was Glenn Waters, or Shabazz Dotson, pardon me, there in the middle of the field. And, you know, those are the types of plays that change momentum. You know, now you're behind the chains on third down, and though I believe the most developed part of Tate Martel's game is his deep passing attack. Got a chance to watch him throw the football, and boy, does it really jump off of his arm. He's used to these distances, and he certainly has the playmaking abilities to convert in these situations. If you're Cedar Hill's defense, you want to back up, keep things in front of you, and wrap up in the open field.
You also may have to watch for the draw. It looked like they were trying to set up the screen. It's not there. Martel with a lot of running room gets a block in the open field. Martel takes it all the way to the 40 of Cedar Hill for a gain of 20. And now this sets up fourth and much more manageable.
Mighty slow to get up on the Bishop Gorman sideline for Cedar Hill.
Now they wanted the screen to Ali Walsh. It wasn't there.
You're right.
He had the entire defense going to that side.
Yeah, great awareness by Tate Martel. Play broke down. Cedar Hill sniffed it out.
So fourth down and nine. Remember, Tate Martel doubles as both quarterback and punter. Caleb Lawton, the senior corner, is down on the field. I think he was the one who took the block from Brevin Jordan when Martel raced upfield. A There's Jordan, one of the top junior tight ends in the country, number two, in fact.
Yeah, you're going to see Caleb here make this tackle. Watch him. He comes off. Great job of fighting off the blocker. Kind of fell awkwardly. And the young man being helped off the field, they'll want him back for sure. The senior looking to play in a game like this to elevate your recruiting status, as we heard from Jerry Hamilton earlier. And you know, this is the type of matchup that when recruiters come in, they turn on this film to see if you showed up on a Saturday night.
Martel punts it away. It takes a sideways bounce. And Bishop Gorman downs it inside the 20 or 22-yard punt. A beautiful summer night here in Texas with Dallas looking out in the distance.
This is business, where everyone wants to stand out. To make your mark, you have to jump with both feet. That's why Keller crushed the quiet classroom and replaced it with a proving ground, where battle-tested professors challenge you through what we call experiential learning. Here, you'll make bold moves, fail, get back up, and leave transformed. Don't come here for something to hang on the wall. Come here to knock down the wall. This is Keller Graduate School of Management. We learn loud.
Amazing sleep stays with you all day and all night. Sleep Number beds with Sleep IQ technology give you the knowledge to adjust for the best sleep ever. The time is now for the biggest sale of the year, where all beds are on sale. Save 50% on the Labor Day limited edition bed. No better sleep, only at a Sleep Number store.
In New York, you gotta deal with New York. The US Open begins Monday, only on ESPN.
The 2016 GEICO ESPN High School Football Kickoff is brought to you by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Cedar Hill felt they were carrying the flag for Texas High School Football. What a crowd tonight. 2,500 seats were added at Longhorn Stadium. 10,000 capacity tonight, and we were told the police and the fire marshal had to turn people away because the stadium had reached capacity.
Hey, when you got a party, that's what happens. So, you know, it's a high school football party, and they're ready for it.
Buckley, forward progress to the 24 for a gain of 6. Cameron Buckley, a Texas A&M commit. And Kevin Sumlin may have lost a lot of quarterbacks, but he has stockpiled some pretty good wide receivers.
Yes, they do. They are dangerous on the outside edges, and they're getting another one for sure.
Speedy Noyle, Christian Kirk there. Ricky Seals-Jones. And Foreman makes his way for a gain of 4. Marquise Foreman, a senior, averaged better than 6 yards per carry last year, but he had a run in the playoff game against South Lake Carroll, a 70-yard scamper. He almost fell down a couple of times, popped back up using his one hand.
Beautiful.
And then gained speed. It was incredible.
His center of gravity is amazing when you watch him. At 5'11", 200 pounds, he's got great balance.
He slowed up that time, no gain. But in that playoff game, you're talking about it was a Barry Sanders-esque run when you watch it. A 70-yard touchdown run with the zigs, the zags, the oohs and ahs. About twice you thought the play was over and he was going down and somehow kept his balance.
And Coach McGuire said yesterday when talking about Williams, he said he's got, you know, at times he can give you the Barry Sanders lateral movement behind the line of scrimmage, and other times he's a one cut back and will get downhill. And this is a young man that if they're going to come back in this game and make a difference, he's got to get going.
With the play clock winding down, Joey McGuire, Cedar Hill's head coach, calls a timeout. 4th and 1, down 10, 5:40 to go here in the third. The first week of the college football season sees some big-time football games being played. And next Sunday, September 4th, Notre Dame and Texas. They played last year in South Bend. The Irish took the Longhorns to Bovine University in that one. Texas will look to repay the favor this time.
Throwback Earl right there. Yeah. I wish he was playing.
Yeah, I tell you what, though, Charlie Strong has a lot of depth. He's got a lot of young guys who got seasoning last year. The question continues to be quarterback. Is Shane Buechele ready? Will it be Shane Buechele? Or will it be Tyrone Swoops?
I think when it's all said and done, and I said it, I think Shane Buechele will be the starter. And if he's not the starter, he will get more reps. So I think when it's all said and done, I think he's your guy you want the ball in your hand on third and long. He's a guy that you want the ball in the hand to try to get it out to some dynamic playmakers that Texas now has out on the outside edges at the wide receiver position. Two talented, dominant running backs, over 250 pounds of muscle. So I think this is an opportunity. If you're Texas, you're really licking your chops, because that's the game, that Notre Dame game, they should be thinking about all year.
Another fake punt to first down and more. Foreman across midfield, cuts it back. There's the shake. There's the bake. Foreman still running. We warned you, didn't we?
Oh, my.
72 yards. And you may see that one again on SportsCenter.
Yeah, I've got a strong feeling. At least four or five guys on the football field touched him. The snap was high. Great change of direction there. Got skinny. Great job of putting the ball across his chest, protecting it. But watch the effort here. Watch the effort. That's what you're looking for. The high knees, the cutback, the moves, and Anish, the strength to finish off the run. When you zigzag like that, you're tired. The guy punched it in. What a fine run. A fantastic finish there from Williams.
Extra point is good by Maverick Montiel. Woo. Hashtag SportsCenter top 10.
Yeah, you see it here. Just a gutsy call from Joy McGuire, and it pays off for the Longhorns as Foreman, doing his best Barry Sanders impression, putting it in the end zone.
This is shaving.
Blades here, blades there, smaller there.
Whoa, that's not a blade. This is Gillette Shielding, with lubrication before and after the blades. Shields from irritation for a close, comfortable shave. Pro Shield from Gillette.
Ask Sherwin-Williams during the endless summer sale. Stop by your neighborhood Sherwin-Williams paint store and save 30% on paints and stains, August 25th through September 5th. Visit sherwinwilliams.com/save to find the store nearest you.
Should only be measured by one thing. How it makes you feel. Introducing the all-new Q60. Infinity. Empower the drive.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. We also have other pain-relieving braces available for shoulder, ankle, and your back. Call the number on your screen right now to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost.
The story tonight offensively for these teams: on the left, Ali. On the right, Foreman.
That's great. You're on fire tonight, big guy.
Biaggio Ali Walsh, who actually is the grandson of Muhammad Ali. Two touchdowns for Bishop Gorman. And Marquise Foreman ripped off a beautiful 72-yard run on a fake punt, zigging and zagging his way through the Bishop Gorman defense. Ali Foreman, that was the rumble in the jungle, right? Yeah. Kinshasa Zaire. I scanned the rosters in the break furiously, could not find a Frazier. Little trouble with that kickoff, but Bishop Gorman able to cover it up.
You want to see Ali? Here it is. That means right up the gut. Nice job there of staying on his feet. And this young man is fast. If you're just now tuning us, one of the fastest players, if not the fastest player for Gorman. And then Foreman would not be outdone. Watch the zigzag here. Great job of getting outside of defenders. And just great awareness. Those high knees there and the power and the finish to punch this in. When you do that, let me tell you, I was an old quarterback out in West Texas, ran the midline option a lot. It takes a lot of energy and effort to do what he just did and to finish that run. Spectacular finish from that young man.
And we had mentioned his run that he had in the playoff game last year against South Lake County. Very similar
yes,
in terms of all the shakes and all the zigs and all the zags. Martel to the air on first down. Jimmy Tellis the catch. Stays on his feet, and he takes Freeman with him for a few extra yards before going out of bounds, a gain of 7. And you look at the statistics in this game, Bishop Gorman has dominated statistically, but it's really been two special teams plays, one a fake punt.
You're right.
One, an actual punt that hit a Bishop Gorman player. They were the receiving team. Cedar Hill recovered. Next play, Avery Davis to Charleston Rambo for a touchdown. And it's a three-point game right now with 5:10 to go in the third. Ali Walsh. That was a big hit by Dimitri Moore. Woo-wee.
And then talking to Coach McGuire, he said, this kid loves to hit. You know, they've got to slow him down in practice. He's the player that even when you've got on shells, he's that guy that brings you to the ground, and you got like, hey, man, chill out. But, you know, that was just a fine play coming off the edge, and he did not go for the Tate Martel fake. Typically, some linebackers will hold off that time, doing a good job of seeing where the ball was going and getting to it.
Horace brother Richard plays at Texas A&M. He's the third more brother that Joey McGuire has coached, and that pass incomplete intended for Jalen Naylor. So fourth and four, and Ahmad quite quickly and quite swiftly, the pendulum in this game is swung.
You are 100% right, Amish. And that call, you got to go back to that special teams call from McGuire. To have that type of nerve during a game like this and to put it in the hands of your players, it's paying off for them now. This energy, the energy from this crowd now is really helping these players. And let's see if they can score on this drive and take the lead or tie.
Rambo lets this kick bounce. It'll die at the 40-yard line. Outstanding starting field position for Cedar Hill. Dimitri Moore, the three-star recruit, laying the lumber on Ali. The momentum on the side of Cedar Hill.
Hard to overstate the energy, the anticipation.
Car wreck can leave your life spinning out of control. You need to get your car fixed and pay medical bills. I'm attorney Glenn Lerner. Call us the moment you've been injured. Let us turn your wreck into a check.
877-1500. Now handling Xarelto internal bleeding and wrongful death cases.
We crushed it last week, buddy.
We.
You scored 2 touchdowns. I put you in my lineup.
We did it.
Without NFL.com fantasy football, what would friends talk about?
You fly often?
Yes.
NFL.com fantasy football. Fun, free, and easy.
Want to make this football season the best ever? Then get the best sports mobile app. It's the new SDN Sports from Station Casinos, and it has it all, like a 50,000 point sign-up bonus. And SDN Sports has great choices like parlays, round robins, teasers, all the ways you like to play. SDN Sports is faster than ever with longer battery life. You even earn reward points for every bet you make. Sign up today at stationcasinosports.com.
We've overused the boxing analogy, but tonight Bishop Gorman has been the team that's been landing a lot of jabs. They're up on the scorecard. They're winning the rounds. What Cedar Hill is doing, they're landing haymakers.
Yeah, they are. And they know they have to get back in this game and to flip the score. So I think you're looking at it right now, and you bring this offense back out on the football field, and quite frankly, they haven't done much against this Gorman defense. It's been special teams that's really helped put them on the board. So if you're Avery Davis right now, you're really looking to give your team a boost and to get them in the end zone.
Davis pumps, checks down to Fleeks. flakes to midfield, tackled by who else? Ie Natiote, who might be the best defensive player in this game, maybe the best player we've seen in this game tonight.
Yeah, he is active. Oh, man, and I really like his motor. It runs pretty darn good. I mean, that guy right there is like a Mack truck. You know, he's big enough to really be forceful inside, but he's also a player that can go to the outside and tackle people in space. It's the ideal defender you want with the way that football is moving now.
The number three outside linebacker in the junior class, so he still has one more year of high school ball. Williams in motion. Davis trying to buy time, nowhere to go, and he goes down, sacked by Ie Natiote, the four-star junior, ranked 113 in the ESPN Junior 300.
This is a coverage sack. Once again, I mean, Avery, I was looking at it downfield. There was nowhere to throw the football. And I said this at the beginning of the game when we were talking about he and Tate Martel. One thing they're special out is making things happen when the plays break down downfield. If I'm Coach McGuire, I'm going to Avery right now and saying, big boy, do not stand in that pocket. When it breaks, you go for it and you pick up some positive yardage and give us another chance to fight.
Bishop Gorman, their first charge.
Timeout by Kenny Sanchez, and maybe here you go over some two-down strategy, because we've seen Joey McGuire roll the dice on some of these fourth downs here in the second half.
He's not scared. I know that much. He's definitely understands that this is a tight game, and those are the plays that can make the difference. He caught Bishop Gorman off guard with the fake punt. This could very well be fourth down territory, and if I'm Coach McGuire, in a three-point game, I don't know, maybe I put a foot to it and try to pin them back, make them go the length of the field. But I think we've got a ball game on our hands for sure.
ESPN's coverage of high school football began this weekend. It continues all season long. We will air 12 regular season games on the various ESPN networks. Catch Recruiting Nation Thursdays at 6 Eastern on the U. The Under Armour High School All-America game January 1st. National Signing Day, which has become a religious holiday now in college football.
Yeah, it is.
February 1st. And right now, Ohio State trumpets the number one class in the country. They've got three Bishop Gorman players, Tate Martel, the quarterback, Haskell Garrett, the D tackle, and Tyjon Lindsey, the wide receiver. Third down and 9 against the blitz. Davis floats it down the sideline, and Foreman can't hold down. They wanted the running back on the wheel route.
They had the right play call. Yeah, that is for sure. No doubt about it. Just a wheel route on the backside. Got the matchup they wanted. Avery put the ball right on the money. And he'll want this one back after having a spectacular run to put them on the board a second ago.
Fourth down and 9. Ball at the 41-yard line. Joey McGuire, Cedar Hill's head coach, has gone for it 5 times on fourth down. He tried a fake punt a couple of times. Any gimmicks here, or is this a clean kick?
Yeah, I think this is a punt. You know, you're within the distance. You know, you're within the range that you'd like to be to make something happen here, definitely.
Richie punts it away. It takes a Cedar Hill bounce inside the 25 and it downed at the 23, a 36-yard punt. And with the way the momentum of this game had gone, Bishop Gorman needed a stop on defense. We told you Ohio State has the number one recruiting class in the country. A big reason why: their ability to recruit Bishop Gorman this year. Tyjon Lindsey, who played with Gorman last year, then transferred out briefly in the offseason, came back not long ago. His paperwork has not been pushed through, and he has a collarbone injury, so that's why he's not playing tonight. Tate Martel, you've seen, is the top quarterback for Bishop Gorman, and Haskell Garrett, the anchor of that D-line. Biaggio Ali Walsh breaks free. Midfield and beyond. Goodbye, Biaggio Ali Walsh. His second long touchdown run of the night, third of the game, and Bishop Gorman just landed a haymaker.
just took the win out of this stadium, out of this team. Once again, I can't say enough about what the interior offensive linemen for Gorman are doing right now versus Cedar Hill. They are winning at the point of attack. They are covering guys up. They're providing the space for Biaggio Ali Walsh to do work. Christian Martinez, Zach Grant, Adrian Duplis, those young men tonight are earning their keep.
A 77-yard run for Ali Walsh, who also had a 54-yard run earlier in this game and a short touchdown run. How about the gaudy totals tonight? 18 for 198.
And those are the types of numbers that if you're another college coach looking, you know, the Cal Golden Bears better keep their eyes out on this guy. There'll be offers still coming in for this young man, especially after tonight's performance. And I have a feeling he's really set up for a big, big senior year. And with Tyjon Lindsey out, we talked about it. I think he's your second best playmaker on this team behind Tate Martel. And he's proven today that he could be, in some games, the best playmaker of this Bishop Gorman team has to offer.
We watched him last year. We came away incredibly impressed. We had a family friend of his, Flavor Flav, in the booth with us.
Oh, good time.
Flavor was very impressed as well.
Indeed.
I think that's what you call him, or Mr. Flav. Either way, but this kid is special, and he gets free, you will not catch him from the backside. He's like the gingerbread man. He's gone.
Yeah. Well, we asked the Bishop Gorman players last year, we're like, who's the fastest guy on this team? And they answered it at the same time and said, Biaggio. It wasn't even close, and he runs so smooth. It doesn't look like he's working all that hard once he gets into full stride. But defenders, that gap just continues to grow once he gets out in front of you.
There's Cameron Fleming across the 20. Ali Walsh is a versatile threat beyond football. He's got the stunning good looks we all wish we had. And I'm sure his Instagram and Twitter following will increase after tonight.
No doubt.
He's also a model. He is a legitimate model. Our stage manager, Annie, is on her phone right now. She's looking up Biaggio Ali Walsh. He signed a modeling contract with Wilhelmina. Mm-hmm. So he's going to go to Cal. He's going to have that modeling contract. And because he signed the contract while in high school, he's allowed to continue to do it and monetize off it when he goes to college. If he did it while he was in college, he couldn't play sports because you can't monetize your name as an NCAA athlete.
I think it's great. You know, and I kudos to whoever set that up and got that in the works. I think it's great for him. Another pressure here coming from Bishop Gorman.
And that was Haskell Garrett coming straight down the middle. The catch was made, but the receiver out of bounds. And there's Garrett, the top-rated player who is healthy and playing in this game, and he's committed to Ohio State.
And in addition to that, you know, that was that time there, you're looking at a six-man pressure. I mean, this entire Bishop Gorman defense, they have been aggressive. And when you send that many guys, you really leave your guys in the back end and the secondary susceptible. If they make one mistake, the other team's fight song is playing. And tonight, you haven't seen those big plays with the exception of the one to Ramo to start the half. You haven't seen this secondary give them up.
Davis downfield, intercepted by Oliver. And now flags, and now the Bishop Gorman bench comes out on the field. Now, we told you it would get chippy. These two teams traded plenty of trash talk on social media going back to March. Kylan Ritchie, the tight end, getting away from
after
whatever
the play,
was happening.
Dead ball, unsportsmanlike conduct. Offense number five. We have a 15-yard penalty at the end of the run. First down, Gorman.
Yeah, they gave the penalty to Ritchie.
Yeah.
This has been a well-played game, except for these unsportsmanlike conduct penalties, which are starting to pile up.
Yeah, this was not great adjusting on the ball in the air from Charleston Rambo. He just got tied up, and it's going to be incredibly difficult to try to make that catch behind your back. And Oliver was in prime position. He actually turned into the wide receiver and went up and attacked this football the way Rambo should have. And I can tell you right now, when you want to gain the respect and the trust of your quarterback, Rambo has to make those plays, and he's made it time and time again for this team. But in a moment like this, when your quarterback gives you an opportunity to go bail this team out, just couldn't quite do it. But a wonderful and fantastic finish there from number 20, Greg Oliver.
Across the middle, too high for Thompson Robinson. Ahmad, to go back to the Oliver interception, the reason Oliver's starting, Malik Hausman would normally start on that side. He's a three-star recruit. He committed to Arizona, but in the offseason, Hausman was hit by a drunk driver while crossing the street. He suffered an awful knee injury. And when we talked to Kenny Sanchez, the head coach for Bishop Gorman, you could tell he was just torn up about the way it happened. But it sounds like Arizona will keep its commitment to Hausman.
Kudos to that school for honoring that. And what a horrendous story. You know, just oftentimes, you know, here's a kid who does things the right way, one of the top corners in Nevada, and when he and Perry are on the field together, you're talking about maybe one of the more aggressive and dominant duos, along with Bolden, you're right, in the country. So for that young man to not be out here, and then for Oliver to get an opportunity, that's what you're supposed to do. Here's a sophomore. He knows he's playing in a big-time game on the road in this type of environment, and to make that type of play. And I said it earlier, I believe that this Cedar Hill team, along with these wide receivers, felt like they had an advantage over Oliver based on his height and his inexperience. He's played today like a veteran.
And he's played against guys going to Oklahoma and Texas A&M.
The leg. Third down.
You get the sense now, Cedar Hill milling in retreat a little bit. And Bishop Gorman, with a score here, would put the Longhorns in a tough position to come back.
Yeah, you're right. And you just said it. If you're the Gaels right now, that's what you're telling them in the huddle. Guys, let's go get this. Let's go complete the mission. This is a business trip for us. Let's go finish it off the right way.
Downfield, caught by Dorian Thompson Robinson, the top junior in the state of Nevada and the future quarterback at Bishop Gorman.
Look, the way he just caught that ball, I'm not so sure if his natural position is wide receiver. Great release right there of dipping his shoulder, getting underneath the defensive back. But his tracking abilities, he just got out, you know, at 6'2", 200 pounds, he's got that long stride, able to really eat up the turf and the grass, got behind coverage and was able to make a big-time catch.
He's got a number of offers, Arizona State, Florida, Michigan, UCLA, they all see him as a quarterback. Martel will keep it up the middle, Martel into the end zone, and the Gaels are starting to pour it on.
That was an aggressive run. Definitely a run from a guy who hasn't not lost a game as the starting quarterback. Just saying that sounds crazy. And he's working really hard right now to get 40 straight games for this program.
He's got the game and the substance to back up the swag, doesn't he?
We said it. You know, and if you're going to talk like that, you better be a bad man. He is.
Officials blow the whistle. Thompson Robinson not able to get in on the fake two-point conversion, but here's the touchdown by Martel. Tate Martel has made it no secret he wants to play at the next level and then the level beyond that, meaning Sundays. Size is the one thing that scouts point to as a deficiency. Can't do anything about that. Kenny Sanchez told us it hasn't been as big of a concern from college coaches. Will it hinder him if he wants to continue his career beyond college?
Look, you know, I've always said it's only a disability if you believe that. You know, here it is. I was a 5'8 corner, played at a very high level, played in the NFL, and that was always the knock on me. I wasn't big enough, but I just kept on fighting through that. I have a feeling when you watch Tate Martel, this kid's just a winner, you know, and if you don't like his moxie and his swag, you know, know, he doesn't really care anyway. But I think that he is a player that can play through his disability, which is being short and being limited in terms of his height. But he does everything else well. He can buy time with his feet. He can throw into tight windows. He's got enough strength to throw intermediate and deep throws. So, I mean, at this point, if you're asking me, I think this is a young man that will go into the college level ready to compete for a starting job.
David Williams to the 26-yard line. Another flag back at the 20. Clark Calvert, the head referee in tonight's game.
Return holding 32, routine team. The 10-yard penalty, first down.
Andre Knox, the guilty party. Tate Martel, ranked as the 7th best dual threat quarterback in the class of 2017. 127th overall in the ESPN 300, committed to Ohio State. He had originally committed to Texas A&M, and that turned into a big story in the offseason when he decommitted on Twitter, which a lot of kids do these days.
Yeah.
One of the Texas A&M assistant coaches, Aaron Moorhead, then went on a passive-aggressive Twitter rant, which, again, as an adult, as an assistant coach at a big-time program, you've got to know better. And then fans came into the foray, and they were tweeting at Martel. They were tweeting at his sister, which, quite frankly, is uncalled for. But A&M paid the price, Tyjon Lindsey said at the time, because of the action of Aaron Moorhead, that assistant coach. He wouldn't look at A&M anymore. And Manny Netherly, an ESPN 300 player, decommitted from Texas A&M after that episode.
That was bizarre.
It was very bizarre.
I was standing by trying to watch and follow it, and I think you're right. You know, in this situation, I know everybody has made a mistake at some point, and I guarantee if the coach for A&M had an opportunity to do it again, he would, because he's got to be the adult there. And I think what it also sets the tone is other recruits, that was kind of a domino effect. There were several other recruits, whether for that reason or not, decommitted shortly thereafter from the program. So you've just got to be careful in this day and age with the way the recruiting is based. Look, anything you say is recorded, whether you delete the tweet, whether you say it or not. Listen, when a story breaks like that, it can jeopardize the way that people look at you and the way that people recruit you. So I just wish that some of these young men would understand that, because some of these decisions they're making are going to affect them for a lifetime.
Third and two for Cedar Hill, down two scores. That missed two-point conversion, Biggs. And the Longhorns get enough for a first down. Yeah, if you're Texas A&M, I'm not sure you should be turning away quarterbacks as it is. Johnny Manziel, remember, left early for the draft. We all saw that coming. Kenny Hill, who won the September Heisman a few years ago, transferred it to TCU. He's now the starter for the Horned Frogs this year. He sat out last year. And then last December, in a short span, Kyle Allen and Kyler Murray, a couple of highly touted QBs, both transferred out of A&M. And then Tate Martel decommitted a few months ago. Avery Davis trying to spin away from a defender he can. He's taken down by Bolden. It's a loss of 6.
Speaking of Bolden, that's what makes him so diverse. You know, he's playing up in and around the box. It just shows you what type of defender he is. You know, I know there are several college coaches watching tonight and will be watching all year to see where this domino falls, because he's a player that, if you're looking to build in your secondary, definitely a guy that can add some serious depth.
Second and long, far side, and that is complete. Rambo, a gain of 8, to take us to the end of the third quarter. An entertaining third quarter. Ali and Foreman both traded a couple of punches. Here's Marquise Foreman. He'll be on SportsCenter later tonight when the top 10 rolls around. And then Ali, 77 yards out. Bishop Gorman up 30-14.
Musco Lighting. We make it happen.
T-Mobile's coverage is unstoppable. With extended range LTE, it reaches farther than ever. Now stream video and music free in more places, and we're not stopping there. Now you're covered even beyond the reach of cellular networks. And with Wi-Fi unleashed, talk, text, and surf anywhere there's a Wi-Fi signal. From skylines to coastlines, out in the country, deep in the city. We got you covered. Come see why more than 24 million people have made the switch to T-Mobile.
Meet the John Deere Gator XUV 590i, a vehicle so versatile, it owns anything outdoors that ends in ing, like hauling, exploring, off-roading, and, of course, braking. 32 horsepower, a 1,200-pound payload, and over 1,000 different ways to configure yours. Go Gator. Now you can own a Gator XUV 590i for as low as $133 a month. Learn more at your John Deere dealer.
Introducing Dunkin's new cold brew coffee. Steeped slowly in cold water for small batches with an ultra-smooth, full-bodied flavor. Discover the craft of cold brew today and keep on. America runs on Dunkin'.
It's the Labor Day mattress event at Ashley Home Store. Get 8 years no interest on Tempur-Pedic and iComfort starting at $21 per month. Plus, add a power base starting at an additional $7 per month. Only at America's number one furniture and mattress store, Ashley Home Store. This is home.
Now, with the all-new, all-American Bacon Boss, you can get the same juicy, crispy, and piping hot restaurant-style bacon with less fat and less calories from your microwave in less time than you could ever imagine. The patent-pending pressure lid seals in the juices, traps, and recirculates the heat while it harnesses all the natural flavors for better-tasting bacon. Turn your microwave into a restaurant-quality bacon press with the all-American Bacon Boss.
Available online or at these fine retailers.
Figure it out.
You're watching the 2016 Geico ESPN High School Football Kickoff, part of the Summer of Next. Presented by Geico with Amon Brooks, Simon A. Schrapp, Bishop Gorman, and Cedar Hill, a couple of star-studded rosters. Bishop Gorman with Ohio State commit Tate Martel at quarterback. Cedar Hill's quarterback, Notre Dame verbal Avery Davis. And it is a 3rd and 7 for Davis as we begin quarter number 4. Davis is hit. The ball rolls incomplete. Nateote again in the backfield, and it's 4th down.
You know what else is happening again? This team has been ineffective on 3rd down. They are now 3-11 on 3rd down. That is a down where if you're a quarterback and you're an offense and you're trying to move the chains and keep your momentum going, you can't falter on that down. And tonight, Cedar Hill has really struggled being 3-11. You saw it there once again, the pressure getting back to Avery and the Longhorns not having an answer for this dominant blitz package from the Bishop Gorman Gaels.
They've tried a couple of fake punts tonight. Jihad Thomas checks into the game. Richie will kick it away. And it goes out of bounds just inside the 45-yard line of Bishop Gorman. A 35-yard punt. Biaggio Ali Walsh, who's run for close to 200 yards tonight. I think that leg work, Don, may have hurt that leg on this play where he doesn't even get the ball. Take one more look.
Yeah, you just watch that left ankle. Kind of got rolled up on there, and you could see him, the grimace on his face. And the right ankle there is what they're working on. Both of those ankles just kind of got twisted up underneath the tackle. And, you know, if you're Coach Sanchez right now, you've got a decision to make. Do you trot him back out on the field, and it looks like they're going to go with their backup running back?
Ahmad Cianelli.
Yeah.
Martel to the air. Naylor makes the catch. And then he's spun to the ground after a gain of 8. Josh Newman with the stop. Newman's dad ran track and played football at UConn. Newman's got a couple of FBS offers, Illinois out of the Big Ten, and Texas State.
And one adjustment that Coach McGuire and this defense has made, they've gone now to a four-down look. I called for it earlier in the ball game because Biaggio Ali Walsh is running right up the middle. They brought in an extra defensive lineman with the hopes that they can stop this play right there.
Zone read, that's Martel. And he lost about a yard. So third and short coming up.
Yeah, and because the Bishop Gorman Gaels went for that two-point conversion, now if you're the Longhorns, it's a two-point game. I mean, you've got to get two extra points, a two-score game, pardon me. So, you know, if you're thinking about it, a stop here is very important. And what the offense does with its next series could determine whether this game will be out of reach towards the latter part of the fourth quarter.
High snap. Martel will keep it. Has running room. And he B-buttons his way to the 40-yard line. A gain of 8, a first down, as Bishop Gorman moves the chains.
Great decision. It's another flag.
You're getting to that point in the game.
Yeah. Yeah, all week long, you've had pictures of the Gorman,
dead ball.
Bishop Gorman,
the play, unsportsmanlike conduct. Offense, number white, 18. It's a 15-yard penalty, first and 10.
Now that time it was Tate Martel, cost his team 15 yards. I'm sure he was talking a little bit, and they've got scoreboard right now. So underneath that pile, as you see, some pushing and shoving, and as a quarterback, I know this. It gets real grimy underneath the pile. You know, twisting of ankles, pulling and pushing on body parts. It's crazy down there. So, you know, sometimes you got to defend yourself. But now you really put your team in a tough spot with as you back them up behind the chains.
Martel again will keep it, and he's tripped up by Moore. A loss of a yard on the play, second down.
Great open field tackle there by Moore.
Or rather, a gain of a yard, so second down and 9. Moore's had a nice game, a 3-star recruit with a number of FBS offers. Arizona State, Arkansas, Cal. And he's seen as a hybrid guy in college. And, you know, the way college football has evolved, coaches now are recruiting football players. If you don't have a position, it's not as big of a deal anymore.
Yeah, tweeners used to be guys that were overlooked. Now you're looking for guys that can play two positions in case one of them doesn't work out at the next level.
Martel downfield. A lot of contact. Intended receiver was Thompson Robinson. No flag. It'll be 3rd and 9.
Tate took a big hit back there in the pocket, but he was able to still stand tall and try to get the ball downfield.
Covers that time by Donovan Collins. You know, to your point about the tweeners, when it's so hard to substitute on defense, you need a guy who can maybe be a safety. And one play he's supporting the run, one play he's covering a slot receiver, one play he's covering a tight end. Here's the blitz. Caught by Jimmy Tellis for a first down. Good pocket presence there by Martel.
Awesome pre-snap read. He felt the pressure. He knew it was coming, knew that that ball had to be out of his hand quickly. And if we were able to see his eyes, you could see it. He recognized it, and immediately he went straight to his target. One thing that makes him very efficient is quick release. Does a good job of getting the ball out of his hands. His throwing motion is fast. It's tight. It's effortless, and I think that's what, at the next level, college coaches are looking for when they recruit this young man.
The scouting report says his quick release is one of his biggest pluses.
Yeah.
Cianelli up the middle. And he's finally taken down, but it's near the marker. It'll be close to a first down. And it's enough to move the chains.
Yeah, for the Longhorns tonight, they just have not had an answer for that play. You know, right up the middle, it has been something that has certainly been a burdensome for this team, and they just haven't been able to figure it out, what the proper adjustments are and the right angles to attack that play.
Martel keeps it on the zone read. He has running room. Martel into space, into the end zone. Six more for Bishop Gorman.
There have been at least four or five times tonight that Tate Martel has put on a play fake that is next level. Once again here, just watch him. Brilliant job there of holding the defense on that fake. You want to keep it in there as long as you can, possibly can, while still making the read. And when he pulled it, the intent to run, he gets that defensive end to cave down on the back, which opens up the edge on the defense. And you see it right here. He just took complete advantage of it. Great run there from Tate Martel.
You look at the scoreboard, 37 to 14. Did you expect anything like this?
No, I did not. And I think one thing that I've been most surprised about is coming into this ball game, and from the scouting report, I thought this Cedar Hill defense was going to be prepared, but this Bishop Gorman offense has been too much.
Tate Martel has done it with his arm. He's done it with his legs as well. A 34-yard touchdown run. Bishop Gorman pulling away.
Guess what I just did?
Built a sandcastle?
Huh. No. I just switched to Geico and got more.
More?
24/7 access online, on the phone, or with the Geico app.
That is more. Go get some mud.
All that more has to be why they're the second largest auto insurer.
Everybody likes more.
I think so.
Geico. Expect great savings and a whole lot more.
What powers the digital world? Communication. That's why a cutting-edge university counts on CenturyLink to keep their global campus connected. And why a pro football team chose us to deliver fiber-enabled broadband to more than 65,000 fans. And why a leading car brand counts on us to keep their dealer networks streamlined and nimble. Businesses count on communication, and communication counts on CenturyLink. CenturyLink, your link to what's next.
In New York, you gotta deal with New York. The U.S. Open begins Monday, only on ESPN.
The 2016 Geico ESPN High School Football Kickoff is brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Downtown Dallas on a Saturday night, and that's the Bishop Gorman contingent that's made the trip from Las Vegas to Cedar Hill, and they are enjoying what they have seen. 37-14, the visitors on top. 10,000 plus was the crowd tonight, the biggest at Longhorn Stadium. They've been quiet for most of the night.
They just didn't have enough outside of maybe a few plays for them to get excited about. And as the stadium, you know, starting to clear out, the fans seeing that this game they would need a miracle to come back and to win this ball game at this point.
On Labor Day, 11th-ranked Ole Miss, led by Chad Kelly, will take on 4th-ranked Florida State. The Seminoles with Dalvin Cook leading the way in the backfield. DeAndre Francois, the redshirt freshman, starting in place of the injured Sean McGuire, will be a quarterback for Florida State. You look at the Seminoles, quarterback is a question mark. They have all the other pieces.
That is a talented bunch. And, you know, and I said it earlier, Clemson's still my pick to win the ACC.
Because of the quarterback.
Oh, it's because of Deshaun Watson, no question about it. But Florida State is one of those teams that if you told me at the end of the year they were the ACC champ, I would not be surprised.
Avery Davis to the air on first down off the fingertips of Kagan Williams, 2nd and 10. Perception is everything. The last two summers going into the season, we looked at the ACC as the league that had zero margin for error, as the league where the champion had to go undefeated, and then maybe even still they could be left out of the playoff. Now the ACC is a team that could potentially get two teams in.
Yeah, I mean, Clemson and Florida State, they look extremely strong and probably two of the top teams in the nation when it's all said and done. So I couldn't agree with you more, and now you question more of the Pac-12 and the Big 12 in terms of their strength. And is this a team that's worthy of being in the college football playoff?
Williams to the 30, 3rd and 5. We're going to keep our eye on number 16 in white, Haskell Garrett, the Ohio State commit, one of three on Bishop Gorman. And he is the highest rated player who is playing in this game, number 112 in the ESPN 300. He's going to be a force to reckon with in the trenches.
He will.
And he's going up against a big guy in Mount Zion, 75 in black, the center.
This is third down. We'll see how much juice he's got left in the tank to chase down the quarterback here.
Davis is tackled by Brock Ridgeroli. And fourth down now for Cedar Hill.
Yeah, and this is a disappointing outcome for the Cedar Hill Longhorns, but they cannot allow this to trip up their next several games, because even talking to Coach McGuire and the staff yesterday, they realize that they've got a gauntlet of games, much like Bishop Gorman. The next four or five games are going to be a challenge, and they play in one of the toughest districts in all of the country. You know there'll be a matchup with DeSoto down the road where they will have to bring their A game. So this is a team that can't sit here and lick their wounds after the night. They'll have to get back on the horse and ride.
Bishop Gorman will take over at the 36, but hang on. Another penalty marker back at the 35, and Garrett is down. The Ohio State commit, Haskell Garrett. He didn't look like he wanted a hand up, but he is struggling to get off the field right now, as Natsuyote and Ridgeroli help him off.
And he just took a cheap shot.
After the play, dead ball, unsportsmanlike, number 21 of offense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
That's Marquise Foreman. Let's watch the replay.
Yeah, frustration has fully set in. Watch it right here on the screen. Just as the camera was fading away. And, you know, and listen, I'll say this. I've been a guy that's done that on that coverage unit. It's not the best thing to do, but sometimes you want to get that lick back.
Hopefully, no more extracurriculars.
True.
In the final 5.5 minutes.
Cox has internet so fast it can power whatever amazing tech the future dreams up.
You push a little button.
100 times more powerful Gigablast internet is here. Bring on tomorrow.
At first, I thought I was just seeing things. But no, it's out there. Something is definitely out there. Whatever it is, it's big. At one point, I swear, we got so close I could smell it. But then, poof, it was gone.
Right.
It exists. The Honda Pioneer 1000. With a best-in-class engine and 6-speed fully automatic dual-clutch transmission. It's the biggest member of the Pioneer family. From Honda.
Tate Martel, the 7th-rated dual-threat quarterback in his class. He's done it more so with his legs tonight.
Yeah, he hasn't been sharp in his passing game. But, you know, when you're a player of Tate Martel's status, it makes it easy to do what he's done. 17 rushes, 98 yards, 2 touchdowns, 198 for Ali Walsh. So together tonight, they have really put this Cedar Hill team under the water, you know, and that's really been the difference in the ball game. They've been able to control the line of scrimmage and to run the football at will.
Martel again, he's over 100 yards rushing. And he's got plenty of room down the sideline. He's got his third touchdown of the game on the ground.
And he picked up a major block downfield from number 14, Dorian Robinson, the backup quarterback who also splits time as a wide receiver. You'll see it come to the right of your screen. When he cuts out right here, just watch the block. Just an aggressive block to clear the way on the member of the secondary. And once again, Bishop Gorman continuing to win on the ground. And they have put on a rushing display tonight.
Extra point is good, and Tate Martel with 147 yards rushing, three rushing touchdowns, including this one from 49.
Yeah, this is why he's a difference maker. You know, like I said, it just wasn't going for him tonight much with his passing, but he's a player that, because his game is diverse and because he has that athleticism that we talked about at the top of the show, even when it's not going well for him, he can still manufacture ways to help his team get points.
His quarterback counterpart, Avery Davis, are you surprised Davis didn't take as many chances in the quarterback run game tonight?
He didn't, but I also say Bishop Gorman didn't give him a lot of space. I mean, they were hovering around him all night tonight, and even on the passing downs where he had an opportunity to run when the pocket broke down, we didn't see the Avery Davis that the Cedar Hill fan base is used to seeing and people who followed this young man's career. He's a dynamic player when the play breaks down, and we've only seen a couple times tonight where he's shown those flashes. And I have a feeling when it's all said and done, this will be a game that he grows from. I've had horrible games where I've disappointed my team as a leader, being the quarterback. And I can tell you this much, you think about it the rest of the week. The only therapy he will get will be next Friday when they line back up and he has another opportunity to come back out here and perform a little bit better.
Cameron Fleming out to the 20, and more flags fly. We've already had 9 personal fouls in this game. The chippiness has just gone to another level tonight.
Yeah, there comes a point when you're a competitor and you're getting beat this bad, if you're Cedar Hill by 30 points. Listen, you've got to choose class over craziness. And I know for some of these young men, this was not the outcome they wanted. And look, there's never a way to describe the feeling of defeat. It hurts, it stings, it burns. You got to keep your composure.
Dead ball. Personal foul, number 9 on the return team. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
That is Kyrie Glenn. Alabama and USC a week from Saturday, about 20 minutes from Cedar Hill. It'll be in Arlington. We also have Notre Dame and Texas on the docket coming up. That's a Sunday game, and boy, just an incredible opening weekend in college football. The best that we've had. That has been the mantra leading up to this. USC, Alabama.
That's a big one.
Notre Dame, Texas, Florida State, Ole Miss. And college football returns, and what a return. That's Fleming to the 16-yard line. Ahmad, to pay off the prologue to this game, which was Cedar Hill carrying the flag, not just for their school and the Metroplex, but for the state of Texas, yeah, and the Texas high school football. Is there any macro conclusion that you draw from the outcome of this game?
Yeah, that Bishop Gorman's really good. And I think it says more about Bishop Gorman and their ability to compete in any state against any team, it doesn't matter, than it does to say about Cedar Hill. I just think, you know, this is our second year in a row that we've been able to be around this program. We said it last year, Anish. I don't know if there's a program in the country that operates as closely as a college program as Bishop Gorman. I mean, that man right there, Coach Sanchez, has done a wonderful job of making sure these players understand how important football is and what it means to win consistently day in, day out. And I can't say enough about this program. I think it says more about them than it does Cedar Hill, though they'll be disappointed. all the great fans in the state of Texas who love football are disappointed right now. But I think it says more about Bishop Gorman.
Starting next Saturday, you and I will be at a different college campus every week. And what we saw in Las Vegas at Bishop Gorman, there are schools that do not have the facilities and the infrastructure. Amazing. And even some, the stadium that Bishop Gorman has. Now, it's not some 50,000 seater, but it is a gorgeous stadium. It is a gorgeous campus. They have all the bells and whistles.
They do.
Of many college programs.
And they're proving tonight that they've got the players as well.
Yeah, no question. Bishop Gorman will get it back. They're less than 330 away from a 40th consecutive win.
This is shaving.
Blades here, blades there, smaller there.
Boom. That's not a blade. This is Gillette Shielding with lubrication before and after the blades. Shields from irritation for a close, comfortable shave. Pro Shield from Gillette.
Ask Sherwin-Williams during the Endless Summer Sale. Stop by your neighborhood Sherwin-Williams paint store and save 30% on paints and stains, August 25th through September 5th. Visit sherwinwilliams.com/save to find the store nearest you.
A car should only be measured by one thing. How it makes you feel. Introducing the all-new Q60. Infinity. Empower the drive.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. We also have other pain-relieving braces available for shoulder, ankle, and your back. Call the number on your screen right now to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost.
Here we go.
Welcome to college football paradise.
Oh, my! Touchdown! Off to the races. Unbelievable! The dream continues. What a feeling.
It's finally here.
The best weekend ever begins September 1st. It runs all the way through Labor Day, the first true week of the college football season. We've already had a little bit of an appetizer. Hawaii Cal from Sydney the other night. And then the FCS kickoff tonight, North Dakota State against Charleston Southern. You and I got to see the Bison during their fifth consecutive championship.
Place is magical.
The Fargo Dome.
Yeah.
New quarterback for Bishop Gorman, Dorian Thompson Robinson, a top 100 junior, and he'll be the quarterback next year. This year with Martel under center, or from the pistol. Dorian Thompson Robinson relegated to wideout, but he's the number one junior in Nevada. And his ESPN scouting report says he is every bit as talented as Tate Martel. And a flag. Cedar Hill used a 72-yard run by Marquise Foreman on a fake punt to get to within 17-14. Since then, all Bishop Gorman. Four touchdowns, a 77-yard run, a 49-yard run. There was a 34-yard run by Martel in there. Cianelli fighting across the 45, and he's a yard shy of the first down, third and one.
Yeah, coming into this game, too, I thought the physicality of Cedar Hill was going to be something that at some point in the game may overwhelm Bishop Gorman. It has been the complete opposite. And, you know, and I'll say this, I think this will be a great learning experience for the Longhorns, but what it does for Bishop Gorman is it really does give them the confidence moving forward that they are the best team in the nation. and that they can go back and unthinkable to win a third straight national title and perhaps go through the season again undefeated.
Third and short.
A little power.
And a first down by Andrew Ruelas. And there is Biaggio Ali Walsh. He is our Geico MVP of the game. 18 carries, 198 yards, three touchdowns, including runs of 77 and 54.
He would have easily went for two bills if he wouldn't have that ice on his right ankle. I'm not kidding. I mean, this kid might have gone for 250 yards. They pulled him out at the right time. I'm sure they want to protect him there. But the young man tonight really put on a show for the fans here in Texas. Yeah, this is how he's done work all day. I mean, just slippery right there. And we said it, if he's even, he's leaving. You know, he's one of those types of players, if you're looking at the back of his jersey, you might as well just stop running. And once again, just smooth and very easy going once he finds that crease in that hole. It's a player that once he gets to the second level, unless you've got a player on top of him, you're not going to slow him down. And we saw it last year versus Chandler to open up the high school football weekend. They have put together 510 yards tonight. This Bishop Gorman offense as they go into victory formation.
And Bishop Gorman is going to come away from Cedar Hill, Texas with a 30-point win against one of the premier programs in football-rich Texas. Good to see that from both coaches after the game. It was a chippy game. Clearly there were some tensions. I don't think we've heard of the last of Cedar Hill. This is still a quality football team. You run into a program like Bishop Gorman. Listen, it's a national program loaded with Division I athletes from all over. And Cedar Hill in the state of Texas, most see them as the team to beat this year with all they have coming back, and they've got a great quarterback, they've got great receivers, but Bishop Gorman nationally right now is just on another level.
They really are. I mean, so much so, you know, there's talk there in Nevada that this program, the people are questioning whether they need to be competing every year. I mean, it's really, they've been that dominant where you've got people now on board saying, hey, we may need to reconsider even having Bishop Gorman play like this. I tell you what, this was a fine display of two awesome programs. I'm happy to be a part of it and happy to share this with you, Anish.
Ohio State, if you're an Ohio State fan, how did you feel watching this game and watching Tate
Martel?
You're
excited and you're ready to go.
We're excited for the college football season to start. One more high school game tomorrow, but that's it for us. 44-14, the final. Pony Express next.